A little bit more higher in the inner part of my eye. A little more higher. Wow, that was good English. Oh, it's downstairs. No. Like my eyeball.
Want me to lick your eyeball?
No, thank you. My beauties, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 43, almost 44, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today, four looks with the So Dope palette by Makeup Obsession. I did an eye swatch video. It is up. I will link it. So yeah, let me show you what she looks like in case you don't know. Yeah, excuse this. I accidentally dug my finger, well, what's left of my fingernails in. So yeah, that was a little bit of an eyeshadow accident. But yeah, here she is. So yeah, I went row by row again just because of I wanted to. That's it. That's the only reason. This is look number one. It's this row. And look number two will be that row. And so forth. Timestamps will be down below in my description box for all the looks. And I will also list the makeup that I have during all the looks. I'm planning to do the same base makeup, but with me, you never know. So yeah, if you want to know what is on my face, just click the show more and all that. That is it. I'm rambling. It's really annoying. Did I say this was the first look? I think I did. I don't know. Anyway, grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up, because here comes look number one. First look is this one, and I have been looking at it, and I kind of think I know what I want to do. So, let's just do it, shall we? Eyes are primed, ready to go, with my eyeshadow base from Kiko Milano. It is still tacky, but it is not wet. I have set only the top part here, just below my brow bone. I'm going to start with a color called Earth, which is a brown. And that is going to go in my crease. I'm looking down first, because I really want to place it in the crease and then blend it up. So I'm pushing my brush in the crease as well a little bit, but because this is a little bit more fluffy, it is actually easier for me to look down than to really poke it in, you know? Next, I'm switching to a smaller brush, which is the Morphe M507 in this case, still in the same color. I'm going to deepen it up a bit. Okay, so now I have kind of placed the shadow where I want it. Now I'm going to blend it up, but because of the shape of this brush, I'm just going to look down a little bit, so it is kind of easier for me to hold the brush against my eye. Okay, back to the first brush again, which still has a little bit left, and I'm just going to blend the edge a little so that it is nice and soft. I'm going to another brush, which is the Morphe M506 for the color called Hemp, which is this green. I'm going to start on the outer corner of my lid. And I am going to blend it in the crease a bit. And I want to keep this green quite low, so really in the socket. If you are hooded eyes, just draw where you kind of want the shade to be. Cute. Back to the first brush. Without any extra product, I'm just going to blend. So I'm going to go back into the matte green called Hemp. I'm just going to intensify it on top of my eyelid. And I'm going to go a little bit further in. Now this is not really a packing brush, but that does not really matter. With my the other small Morphe brush that I had, I'm going to go back in the color called Earth, and it's going to go underneath my eye. And basically I'm starting at the outer corner and then I'm dragging it in to follow the shape, you know? Let's kind of build up the bottom lash line, because as I said, I have an idea. So first I need an eye pencil. So I have here an eye pencil from Estee Lauder. It's a gold one, but I have, I think, four different kinds of golds. And this is the gold that kind of comes closest to the shimmer I'm going to use. I also want it a little bit lower, so that shimmer has a little bit of a grip. With a very tiny brush, I'm going to go into the color called Couche. I'm going to spray it a bit to help against any fallout after I have put some on my brush. And I'm going to press it on top of the eye pencil. Okay. A little bit of that green matte. I'm just going to run it right below that gold. Yep, to tie it all in. Okay, one shimmer left. I don't want to see how it works with the glitter primer, so I have here my NYX Glitter Glue. I'm taking a flat brush, a little bit of a dot on the brush, just a tiny amount, and that is going to go on my eyelid. Now, where I don't have any shadow yet, I'm going to swipe it on. And then where I have the shadow, I'm just going to pat over. Okay, let's also kind of put it here. I have a little bit extra. I'm just going to put it around my tear duct. Okay, I'm going to let that sit for just a second. And then with the same brush, I'm going to go into the color called Relax. It's going to go on top of the primer. I'm just going to press it all. This is so pretty. Now, that glitter primer makes it more intense. But also, especially because my eyes are older, I kind of like having that extra grip, you know? And because I put that matte down there, it kind of gives a little bit more extra base, you know? So you get a little bit more of a gradient. I want that green matte a little bit higher here. Just in the outer corner, and I'm going to concentrate it, that part of my eye. Blend it up a bit. I'm just going to blend over here just to make sure everything is nice. Cute. Do I want to intensify the brown? I think I do. So I'm going to go back to my fluffy brush in the color Earth. And I'm just going to, while looking down, I'm basically placing it on the lower part of my bone. Then I'm just going to kind of blend the edge a little. So both eyes are done. What I'm going to do is I'm going to work here. And first I'm going to grab the color called Relax, which was the same that I put on top. What am I doing? I don't know. So I'm just going to connect it around my tear duct. And just make sure that I have it where I want it. So a little bit more higher in the inner part of my eye. A little more higher. Wow, that was good English. Then I'm going to go to the color Kush, which I have there. In the same brush, I just cleaned it off on a microfiber towel in between. And I'm going to mix. I'm just going to place it over. Then I'm going to go back to the color Relax, which was that first shimmer. So I'm basically going to sandwich it a little bit. And make sure that it is nice and, I don't know, blend it, kind of tie it all in, you know. Back to the color Kush, which is a goldeny shimmer. Just for the inner part here where they kind of meet. I kind of like that. Okay, inner corner highlight. I have here my BH Cosmetics Duo Highlight Palette. I love this palette so much. So, the color Double Take. Sorry for the shine. This color. It's going to go in the inner corner. Yeah, that ties it all in together. I'm going to put eyeliner on, mascara, and then I will be back to show you the look just before the falsies. It's very difficult to talk English today, apparently, so there's that. Here is the look just before the falsies. And for once, I was kind of able to keep the eyeliner pretty low, for my standards at least. So yeah, I'm going to put on my falsies, which are going to be my Sosus In Style London that I got at Primark. I'm also going to choose a lippy, and then I will be back to show you the finished look. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. Everything is on, and here is the finished look. And I really like how this turned out. I feel very, very pretty. The lip combination is a pencil from Catrice, a lip foundation pencil in the color Cool Brown. And then filled in is, no, not filled in. On top of that, yes, is a Revolution cream in the color Hustle. And it is actually this color. But when I put it on top of the pencil, this comes out. So it's a little bit darker. But I still really like it nonetheless. So yeah, I think that is it for the first look. Let me know down below what you think of it. And let's get ready for look number two. Look two is this row. I am going to start with the color 420. This one. Yes. I have done my eyeshadow base, but I haven't set it. So there is that, so that the shadow has the maximum can stick the best. That's what I wanted to say. It's, I'm just going to place it here in the front part of my eye. Basically tapping and swiping a tiny bit. It's a very, very pretty color. I'm keeping it quite low. So now I'm going to concentrate on blending the edge a little bit, and it could very well be that I kind of need to grab a little bit extra. I am doing circles, and here in the beginning it is okay if it goes up a little bit higher. I'm experimenting, that's basically it. Okay, a little bit more. I'm even blending it a little bit on my lid because I don't know why. Okay. I'm grabbing a smaller brush. I'm grabbing my Morphe. Oh, this was a Jessup 231 Luxe Petite Crease, by the way. I forgot to mention it. Now I'm going to go to my Morphe M506 in this case. And the color called Smoke, which is the darkest matte in the palette. I'm going to start by placing it low and then blend it up and into that green. First, I'm going to drag it forward a bit and then up and forward. I kind of like this, so I'm going to go back to the first brush, which has maybe a tiny bit of that green left and there. And I'm going to pull this lighter green on top of the darker green a bit, to make sure that that shape is a little bit better. I'm grabbing actually a little bit more of that lighter green shade. Sometimes I just work in reverse. I kind of have an idea usually, but not really a set plan, because every time I have a plan, it kind of goes out the window. Back to the color Smoke, which was the darkest one, just a tiny bit extra so I can blend it up a bit. Okay, and I'm also kind of connecting my top lash to my bottom eyelash thingy. And just dragging a little bit of that darker green down. I want that color Smoke that I just used, the darkest green, underneath my eye a little bit as well, but I want it right underneath my lashes. So I'm doing the sexy face and I look down and I hold my mirror a little bit more up. Let me grab my NYX Glitter Primer and the flat brush, and I'm going to start with putting a little bit of the primer on my brush and putting it on my eyelid. Let's grab the color Blaze, which is a gorgeous, gorgeous dark brown shimmer. I also used this one in not really my first impression, but the first eye look that I did. I will link it down below. So pretty. I'm just pressing it on. Then I'm grabbing my Morphe brush and I'm just going to blend over the edge a little. Yes, grabbing a little bit of that color Smoke, the darkest green, and really pack it on the outer corner here and blend a bit so that it flows a bit nice and I don't have a harsh wall line where that brown stops. I am going to pull it in a little bit more. Yes, I'm grabbing an eye pencil. I have here my L'Oreal Infallible in Super Cooper. Cute. Let's grab a smudging brush and smudge a little bit of that eye pencil. I'm actually grabbing a little bit of the color Blaze that I just used. I'm going to spray it and I'm going to put it on top. Oh, I like that. Okay, I have one shimmer left though. So I'm searching for a small brush. And it's a very, very small brush. I'm going to go to the color Grass, which is the Cutesy Green Sea. I like this shade. I'm just going to stamp it on top. And then on top of that brown, dragging a little bit. I will blend it a little bit more later, but I also want it up. I'm going to place it on top of that green to get a little bit of, lightness in my inner eye part area. Okay, I also want it underneath here in the corner. Okay, inner corner highlight. I think I can just use my face highlight that I have here from Miss Rose. It will be linked down below. I'm just going to grab a brush. This is a kind of a, almost a champagne-y. Oh, that does nice things to that green. Very cute. Oh yes, I'm going to blend those. So I'm grabbing my brush that I used for the brown shimmer. A little bit of brown shimmer on the top, then a little bit of the grass on top. And I'm just going to flip my brush on the border. So one side green, one side brown. Until I'm happy. And basically, I am happy. So what I'm going to do is finish off that eye. I don't think I need liner. So mascara is on one eye. So like that. This is how it kind of looks with mascara. I'm not going to use liner because the eyeshadow is so dark. So yeah, let me do that and I will be right back. Everything is on and here is the finished look. I am really happy with how it turned out. I feel really, really pretty in it. So yeah, that's always a good thing, isn't it? The lippy I paired it with is one from L'Oreal. It's one of their Rouge Signatures in the color I Stand. And it is a... yeah, this one, a little bit of a... I don't know. It's a darker brown. It's a mid-tone... I don't know. It's a darker brown. And I felt it complemented the shimmer that I have going on very, very nicely. So yeah. This was look number two. Let me know down below what you think of it. And let's get ready for look number three. Look three with the So Dope palette. And I tried something new with my brows today. And I kind of feel like I have hairy caterpillars on my head. So I don't really know if I like it. So yeah. Maybe I just need to get used to it. I don't know. I have here... What is this? This is one from Real Techniques. I really don't like this brush, but maybe I can use it now. My eyeshadow base is still tacky, and I think I have an idea. Let's see if I can execute it though. So let's start with the color Serene. And I want to pack this on my eye and see what happens. Yeah, I thought so. You just don't see it. So let me just do the same thing on the other side so that they're kind of even... Let's put it as an inner corner highlighter base, because that is, I think I can make this one show up in summer when I'm darker, but now it's not really it for me. So let me just use it then for underneath my brow, because I do want to use it today. I'm going to, well, basically work with the shimmers today and we will see from there. So let me get a brush. I'm going to start at my lower lash line, actually. I have my NYX Glitter Primer and a brush. It's not a flat brush today, because it is the brush that I want to use. And I'm going to put it underneath my eye and around my tear duct. I'm going to start there. I'm going to tap in the outer corner a little. But I kind of want to be able to blend them on my lid, I think. Wow, yes, I know. I'm going to start with the color Space, which has that golden shift. And I'm going to press it on my eye. And I'm also kind of flicking it up so that my hairs here kind of are lifted a little bit back up again. Now, the reason I didn't put a pencil down is because I don't know if I want a teal or gold. So I'm just going to do this first. Okay, and I'm also going to put it on my outer corner. And I want it in my crease. I'm going to just use this brush, but without the glitter primer. I'm just going to place it a bit to get that definition. I don't really mind all shimmer looks. I don't do them a ton. I don't mind them though. I'm just going to pull a little bit of that pigment forward just to get a hint of something. I'm actually going to switch brushes. To one that is a little bit more fluffy and still in that color. I'm just going to place it. Now I'm going to dip into the color Serene, which is the only matte that I have. And I'm going to blend on top of this to just help diffuse that color even more. Yeah, let's get a flat brush and my NYX Glitter Primer and just put it on the eyeball. Hey, black bananas. Hey, baby. What are you doing, my child?
I am a lime.
You are what?
A lime.
A lime. Oh, a lime. Yeah, I thought you were a banana. Like,
you're an expert of colors. What color is this?
Yeah.
Those are wheat plants.
Yes.
It's weed.
Yes, I know.
I think it's a bit lime green. Light lime green.
It's neon.
I don't know what it is.
It is neon. So I'm certain it is a neon-y, greenish yellow, yellowy green. Why do you all have yellow in
hemp.
Your hair?
Kush.
Yes, this is with CBD oil.
So if you lick it, you get stoned?
I don't think so.
Maybe try. It's not tasty, at least.
No, it's eyeshadow, hon.
Now my finger is green.
Yes.
Oh, I have a green finger. I don't know if you can see.
No, you need to pull it back a bit. A little bit more. Yes, now they can see.
My finger is green now.
Yes. Like my eyeball.
Want me to lick your eyeball?
No, thank you. Do not lick my eyeball, you monster. Go shower.
I am.
Okay. Sweet. I'm going to go into the color mood, and that's going to go there. Okay, and then here I'm going to, I don't know, wiggle. I'm going to grab that other color called Space on the other side of this brush to help blend them a bit. Just going to tap over. Basically, I have a gradient going on now from that goldeny shade to the, well, teal. I don't even know what it is, what color this is. It's very cute though. Okay, I kind of want the color Mood here underneath my eye as well a little bit. Yes. Now the color Chill for me is better with my finger, but because I have pretty long nails, I'm actually going to use my glitter primer. So I'm going to put a little bit of glitter primer on the back of my hand and then work my brush in. Then grab the color Chill and put it in the inner corner. Tap off a bit, otherwise I'm glittery all over. Actually want it there too. Grabbing a little bit of the color Mood, which was that goldeny. I'm just going to put it a little bit higher here in the beginning of my eye. With a finger I'm going to go into Chill and I'm going to... Now that is better, yes. That is kind of more where I want it. I don't really like it in the inner corner. But it is there nonetheless. So yeah, it is something different. I don't know though if... I think I'm missing a darker matte there. But I don't have it. So I'm going to go with a blending brush in the color Space, which is the tealy shade. And I'm going to place it here. So that it is a little bit higher and it lifts my eye a little bit more. I'm just going to pull it over that gold until about halfway. I will get a little bit more definition when I put my falsies on. So yeah, I do kind of like it. So that is good. I'm going to do the other eye, put on liner and mascara, and then I will be back to show you the look just before the falsies. So hold on tight. I also need to choose an eye pencil, don't I? I think I will grab... I have the goldeny one here from LA Girl. Let's put that in. Yeah, I think I kind of like that. And then I'm going to connect it here. Okay, let's smudge it a little bit. Yeah, I think that's fun. So now I'm going to do the other eye. Liner mascara, and then I will be back to show you the look just before the falsies. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. Liner and mascara is on. And I think it's cute. So, yeah. I am going to put on falsies, choose a lippy, and then I will be back to show you the finished look. So everything is on, and here is the finished look. I really like how it turned out. I was kind of worried because the matte was very, very light. So I had also kind of in the back of my mind thought maybe I need to grab another matte from the palette, which I could have done, but I didn't want to because the whole point of going row by row is that I go row by row, you know? So yeah, let me know down below what you think. Oh, before I forget, let me tell you about the lippy. it's a combination between a lip pencil and a lipstick pen, whatever. Lip pencil is from Kiko Milano in the color 536. And it is a very, very cool toned, dark brown. Very, oh, love it. 2 bits. And this one from NYX, which is a lingerie push-up in the color Corset. Now, what I didn't know, this is actually the closest I am coming to my NYX Butter Gloss, color-wise. So, yeah. What I didn't know is that this contains a minty. So, yeah. I did not know that, but now I do. So, there's that. Oh, yeah, and the earrings I actually made this morning. And I think they're very, very cute. I can make them in bronze as well. So, yeah. Let me know down below what you think of this look. And let's get ready for look number four. Look four. Eyes are primed and ready to go. I haven't set them to give the shadow maximum gripping amount thingy, whatever. This is the look, at least these are the shades I'm going to use today. I have been thinking, which is sometimes good, sometimes not. I'm going to start with the color High. And I'm going to put that on my eyeball first. I really have no plan, other than I know I want to start with this color. Oh yeah, I actually did quite a fun thing, or at least I think it was a fun thing. I did film it, but let me know if you want to see it. I have actually filmed putting on my base makeup with a makeup eraser, with this one. So if that is of interest to you, let me know. I thought it would be fun. Okay, so now I'm just going to concentrate the blending on the edges. And it is okay if it is a bit higher here. That is the way that I place the shadow, so that's good. Okay, I also want to connect it underneath, but I need a slightly smaller brush for that. I am going low, but I am making sure that I'm following my eyelid up or down, whichever which way you want to look at it. I'm still working in this color called High. I'm just really building it up. The next color I'm going to use is the color called Baked, which is a warmer toned, I don't know, orangey brown, yellow brown, I don't know. It's going to go underneath my eye, on my lash line. And I haven't really decided what I want to do with this color, so that's why I'm placing it there, so that I know that I have used it. Let's kind of connect it a tiny bit here. Okay, I'm cleaning the fluffy brush that I use, and I'm going to grab a face powder. This is the Revolution Matte Base in P2, and I really like to use that powder to kind of blend out the edges a little bit more without adding any extra pigment. Just make sure that I have kind of a softer wash of color here. Or a nice blend, that was basically the word I was looking for. It's difficult. I'm going to grab my Morphe, what is it, M507 in the color called Baked, this one. That orangey brownie. A little bit here. Okay. How am I going to tackle that? I think I'm going to use this brush, which is going to probably create a lot of fallout, for the color called Stone instead of a glitter primer. I'm working it into the crease because I kind of wanted to use the base shade to give a light definition. Now I'm going to go back to the color Baked, which is that brownie. I'm just going to put that on top because I kind of want to make this a little bit cooler. There I am. I'm grabbing a brush. Duh. I'm going to go to the color Stone. I'm going to spray it and it's going to go underneath my eye on top of the mat because I don't like that, the way it's looking. Going back to this brush in the greeny, light green mat, and I'm going to run it underneath a little bit. I am going to go back to the color Baked, which is the brown. I'm going to put it here to go below the shimmer I'm just going to put down in a minute. Glitter primer, flat brush. I'm going to put the glitter primer there and tap a little bit on top of that there. Okay, I'm going to go into the color Stone, with the one that I also have on the bottom. And then here, I'm just going to swipe in. And the color changes a little bit because I put down that brown first. Then with a fluffier brush, just a little bit of the color stone, I'm going to blend the edge here a bit, so it's nice. I like that. Now I have one shimmer left, and that is the bright green. And the bright green I kind of want to put there. I don't know if I like that, but we shall see. And it is this color. I'm kind of going to put it in around the tear duct as well, and then a little bit in the inner corner. Now I'm flipping the sponge tip for without product, and I'm going to drag it over so that it kind of blends. I do have an eye pencil that kind of fits, ties in with that, don't I? Yes. So let's get my Kiko Milano eye pencil in the color 7. Which is basically the same color as that. I think that is cute. I do, however, kind of need to re-intensify the color on the bottom. So I'm cleaning the sponge tip on the towel that I have. Because I'm lazy, that's the only reason. I'm going to go to the color stone. I'm going to intensify it. It's turning a little bit greenish. But that's because of the eye pencil. Okay. I am going to grab the color Peace, which is the green shimmer. Just for the outer corner here. And then the other side in the color Stone. It's going to go. I am taking my first brush in the color High, which was that bright green. I'm just going to run it over. I don't really know what kind of color came out of here, but I'm going to try and replicate it here. I'm going to put on liner and mascara, and then I will be back to show you the look just before the falsies, so hold on tight, don't go anywhere. Liner and mascara is on, and here is the look just before the falsies. I also changed the earrings. So yeah, oh yeah, and before I forget, I put another eye pencil on top of the green. This one from LA Girl in the color, what is it, Goldmine? Yeah, Goldmine. I put on top to kind of tone down that brighter green a little bit, because it was kind of annoying me. So yeah, what do you do about it? I'm going to put on my falsies, choose a lippy, and then I will be back to show you the finished look. So hold on tight. Don't go anywhere. Again. Yeah. Everything is on, and here is the finished look. I feel like an evil sorceress. I haven't worn a green lip in ages, and I thought, you know, today is the day. So the lippy I chose is from Carity. It's the matte in the color, what is it, Matcha Gracias. And then on top of that, I wanted it a little bit sparkly. So I just plopped a gloss on top from Essence. This is in the color Let It Go. Just a tiny, tiny hint of a sparkle and a shine, you know. So yeah, the falsies I ended up picking are actually not my Londons. I know it's shocking. They are in the style Dubai, but they are not very different. They are a little bit longer maybe than the ones that I normally wear, but not by a lot. These were the looks with the So Dope palette. 4 rows, 4 looks. In total I did 5, because I also did kind of a, not really a first impression, but something along those lines, you know? So yeah, let me give you my thoughts on the palette. They are not very revolutionary. It's a very good quality. The shimmers work beautifully on top of a glitter primer. You can spray them, then they get a little bit if you don't have a glitter primer. Some of the mattes are best used on a tacky base, like for instance this one, because it is so light. It is best just packed on a tacky base, and then you can see it better. This color for me does not really show up. I can use it to kind of lighten up the inner corner. I can, but this is just because it's almost my skin tone, or maybe a tiny bit lighter. The shimmers all work beautifully. This one I prefer to use with a finger. You can use it with a brush, but then you have a lot of fallout. So I prefer to use this one called Chill with a finger. And I think that's basically it. I really like the color story. I love the quality. So yeah, is it worth its money for me? Definitely. I am going to film a separate kind of a review as well, comparing it to the avocado palette. So yeah, but if you are not interested in that, at least you know what I think about the palette. That was it, guys. Let me know down below if you have a favorite and what you think of this look. This was it, guys. This was my 4 looks with the So Dope palette. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, fabulous evening, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye guys.